In the previous video, we talked about what's an ECG and how to perform an ECG on a patient. In this video, we learn about understanding ECG leads and how they represent different walls of the heart. There are two main categories of leads, limb leads and precordial leads. Let's take a closer look at the limb leads. When the electrodes are connected at the distal end of the arms and legs, it can also be understood as these electrodes are connected at the four corners of the trunk. So, in relation to the heart, the red electrode lies at the right top corner, the yellow electrode lies at the left top corner, the green electrode lies right below the heart, and the black neutral electrode lies below, but slightly towards the right. For understanding purpose, let's remove the limbs from the picture. The red and yellow electrodes connect to form lead 1 in the direction of yellow. The red and green connects to form the lead 2 in the direction of green. And the yellow and the green connects to form lead 3 in the direction of green. These three leads form the Einthoven triangle. Now, coming to the augmented leads, three unipolar leads are formed with near zero polarity from the center of the body to a positive polarity in the direction of green, yellow, and red electrodes. Namely, AVF lead in the direction of the left foot, AVL lead in the direction of the left shoulder, and AVR lead in the direction of the right shoulder. These leads are known as the Goldberger's leads. Now, if you take all these leads and align them to the center, lead 1 will be at 0 degree, lead 2 will be at 60 degree, lead 3 will be at 120 degree, lead AVF, which is straight down, will be at 90 degree, lead AVL will be at minus 30 degree, and lead AVR will be at minus 150 degree. Now imagine the trunk of the body as a house with the heart at the center. There are three windows at the bottom end, namely 2, AVF, and 3. If you were able to look through these windows, what wall of the heart will you be able to see? It's the inferior wall, which means lead 2, lead AVF, and lead 3 represent the inferior wall of the heart. Therefore, any pathological changes in the inferior wall may show some electrical changes on these three leads. Coming to the left lateral wall, we have two other windows, namely 1 and AVL. If you were able to look through these windows, what wall of the heart will you be able to see? It's going to be the higher aspect of the left lateral wall. Therefore, any pathological changes in the high lateral wall may show some electrical changes on these two leads. Now, there's another window on the opposite side, which you might have guessed by this time, is the AVR lead. It gives us some information of the right upper portion of the heart and not very specific. Let's talk about the precordial leads, or the chest leads. We have six electrodes, V1 to V6, placed at specific locations on the precordium, like we explained in the previous video. Each forms a lead from a near zero polarity from the center of the body in the direction of each electrode we placed on the chest. Now coming back to the house we were explaining about. Since V1 and V2 are placed on either side of the sternum, it will be as if you were looking from the roof of the house by removing two tiles on either side of the midline. And you probably be looking at the septum of the heart. And V3 and V4, which are placed slightly to the left, will be as if you were looking at the anterior aspect of the heart. V5 and V6, which are placed on the lower aspect of the left lateral wall, will be as if you were looking at the lower lateral wall of the heart. But if you were to consider lateral wall as a whole, you can include other leads, lead 1, lead AVL, along with V5 and V6. The take-home message is, lead 1, AVL, V5, V6 represent lateral wall of the heart. Lead 2, AVF, and lead 3 represent inferior wall of the heart. V1 and V2 represent interventricular septum. And V3 and V4 represent anterior wall of the heart. I hope you have got some idea about ECG leads and what they represent. If you have any queries or feedback, do let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.